So this is the VPN that I'm using when I want to protect my online activities. Now, I know lots of you use Ipvanish, some of you use NordVPN or some of the other VPN providers. Now, for the most of you, you start the application, you click on connect and away you go. But Ipvanish has some really good settings tucked away in the config. Now, these settings, if used properly, can give you faster performance. If your ISP is throttling you, they can help you get around that. Now, one of the most common things people ask me is, as soon as I enable my VPN, I can't cost my device anymore. Well, in this video today, I'll show you exactly how you can fix that. And I'll also take you through some of the other hidden settings, which can really help you out. So with all of that being said, let's get started. Okay, so the first setting that we're going to look at is called split tunneling. Now, for us to understand exactly what split tunneling is, let me first explain to you exactly what a VPN is. So a VPN stands for Virtual Private Network, and it's a method of connecting to the internet or to another network in a secure manner where your traffic is encrypted. So let's just put that into real life. So right now, if I want to access Netflix or, you know, to a website, my computer will make a connection through my ISP, and from my ISP, I'll make a connection to Netflix, and then I'm then able to stream that content. So if I want to watch a movie or, you know, stream a TV show, I can do that. Now, if Netflix were able to check their logs, they would see that this IP address belonging to Tech Doctor in the UK has made this connection and is currently streaming The Walking Dead, for example. Now, in the case of VPN, if I do install a VPN onto my computer or onto my Android box or onto my Fire Stick, the job of that software is to basically encrypt my traffic. So what that means is, before my traffic actually leaves my computer or my Android box, the VPN software will encrypt that traffic and it'll create a secure tunnel to a VPN server that I choose. So let's say, for example, I decide to choose a VPN server in Canada. So the VPN software will encapsulate and encrypt my traffic and send it directly to a VPN server in Canada. Okay, so as we saw, guys, the key thing about a VPN is that you create a secure tunnel from your Fire Stick or your Android box or your computer from those devices onto a VPN server. So all of your traffic is going through that secure tunnel. Now, if you create a split tunnel, what you're basically saying is, for those certain applications, don't go via the secure tunnel, just go directly to the internet. Okay, so why might you want to create a split tunnel? So let's say, for example, I'm using the CTS Play application. And with this application, I can cast things to my TV, I can search for things online, and if I do find any content online, I can then stream that to my TV. Now, the trouble is, if I have the VPN enabled, my device can't make a connection to my Fire Stick because the VPN is basically blocking all that traffic because everything has to go via that secure tunnel. So let's say, for example, I'm doing the search to cast. Let's say we found some episodes here. So if I click on one of these, so do you want to cast this to your box? Let's click on OK. Now, because the VPN is running, it can't actually make that connection, which is why this casting now fails. So this is exactly where split tunneling would come in and fix this for us. So let's now put that into action. So I'm going to click on split tunneling. Now it's going to ask me which applications you want to basically bypass your VPN. So let's go down. Here we can see there's CTS Play there. Let's click on that. Okay, let's back out of this again. Let's back again. Let me now disconnect the VPN. So once again, my device has now just made a secure tunnel to a VPN server, but because of the split tunneling, I should now be able to talk to CTS Play. So let's test that again. Okay, so we're back to the same screen. Let's see if I can cast one of these. Let's click on that. Do you want to cast this? Let's click on OK. And there, guys, we can see within 1 second, even though my VPN is running, I can now cast this directly to my Fire Stick without any problems. Let's back out of that. And there we have the first benefit of using a split tunnel when using our VPN. And guys, just for clarification, so this is just one example of using the split tunneling. So you can use split tunneling for any application that you don't want to use via your VPN. So for example, if you are paying for Netflix, if you have certain applications that you want to make sure you get maximum performance, that you don't care about a VPN, you can add all of them into the split tunnel, and that way you can keep your VPN running, but those key applications will always go direct. Okay, so next up we have LAN access. Now the way I use Kodi in my house is I have a NAS drive with all of the movies that I previously purchased, and I use Kodi as a media player to access that NAS. Now, once again, as soon as I enable my VPN, my Kodi can't access anything on my network because as soon as the VPN comes up, it isolates everything on my device. So how do we get around that? So this is exactly what allow LAN access means. So even if your VPN is running, having this thing ticked means you can still access everything on your network. So in my case, I should be able to access my NAS and access all of my content. So let's just try that now. So I go to my home screen. Let's open up Kodi. Let's go to Files. Now this folder here, as we can see with the icon, is basically a network folder on my NAS. So if I click on this now, Kodi will try and make a connection to my NAS and access my movies that I own. Let's click on that now. Now again, because my VPN is running, it cannot make that connection because everything on my device is currently isolated. So this is how we fix it. So let's go back to our VPN. Let's go back into settings, and now we're going to say allow LAN access. So because this thing is ticked now, we can access things on our local network even if the VPN is running. So let's test that again. Okay, we're now connected. Let's go back to Kodi. Because of that LAN access, let's see if that now works. Let's click on Files. Let's click on Films. And there we have it, guys. We now have access to our NAS drive even though the VPN is up and running. So that's exactly what allow LAN access will give you. Next up, we have VPN protocol. So the two options we have here is either we use TCP or we use UDP. Now, without being too technical, let's just say with TCP, we establish the connection first. We make sure the other side is listening. Once we've established the connection, we then send the data we want to send. With UDP, it's a case of I'm just going to throw out data and just hope it gets to the target destination. So we can see with UDP, it would have less overhead, but it generally means it's faster because you're not waiting for that connection to establish first. With TCP, you have to connect first, make sure you're fully connected before the data transmission can start. So out of the two, I found better performance on Ipvanish if I change the protocol to UDP. So let's click on that now and let's select UDP. So try this out on your end as well, but for me, definitely, I found better performance with UDP. Okay, so next up we have port. So as previously mentioned, certain ISPs will actually throttle you if they do detect you are using a VPN. Now, we know with VPNs, they can't actually inspect your traffic, but they can, for example, know that your device has made a connection to a VPN server, although once again, they can't inspect the traffic. Now, if they know you're making that connection, some ISPs are known to throttle VPN traffic. Now, one of the things we can do to get around that is basically change the port that our VPN client communicates on. So if you click on that now, you have three options to choose here. So if you do find that over time, your VPN seems to have got slower and slower, it's definitely worthwhile changing the port. I would basically choose 443, which is the standard port for secure communication. So when your device is connecting to Amazon.com or if you're doing banking or any site that has the padlock, which is an SSL secure site, you are talking to that site over the standard 443 port. Now, if you change your VPN to use the same port, then hopefully your ISP will just think that's normal traffic, not special VPN traffic. So definitely have a look and check what port you're using. And once again, if you have noticed that over time, your VPN speeds have slowed down, then it's definitely worthwhile going in here and changing that speed. Now, the last thing to think about is instead of clicking on best server, it's always worthwhile looking at the server list and try and find a server that has the lowest latency, because that means that server is the closest to you. So in theory, that should give you the best possible performance for your VPN. That's all for this video, guys. Many thanks for watching. If you did find it useful, then do give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more stuff like this, then do subscribe and make sure you hit the notification bell. Do leave me a comment below. Let me know what you thought about these tips, and I'll hopefully catch up with you guys real soon. Thanks. Thanks again for watching, guys. Oh, and if you're interested in a VPN, if you click on that link on the bottom left, you'll get a great 46% discount. If you are worried about your privacy and you want to stay safe online, I do recommend you check out a VPN. Thanks again, guys. See you on the next one.